بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الحمد لله we're back with another lecture with our respected Imam, Sheikh and my teacher as well and my uncle Dr. Naeem Rehman. And this lecture is titled The Month of Qur'an. As we know, we are in the blessed month of Ramadan and the days are going by very quickly. And we do need to make the most out of our time. Alhamdulillah, this is a unique opportunity that we have where for a lot of us, we have not many responsibilities, you know, in terms of work. We're at home with our families in the comfort of our own homes. And we have a lot of time. And we need to make the most of this time which is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a ni'mah from Allah, and we need to make the most of it. So inshallah, without further ado, we will begin today's lecture, and the lecture is titled The Month of Qur'an.
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ My dear brothers, my sisters in Islam, we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the only Lord of this universe. He is the only creator. And we bear the witness that none is worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we say best of our salutations and greetings upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we bear the witness that he is the last messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he is the most beloved one to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he is the best one of all the humanity. My brothers, we are in the month of Ramadan, and the time is going very quickly. The time is passing very quickly. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَات, that these are counted days, limited number, only a small number of days. We can count them on our fingers. So the time is going very quickly. We need to get the benefit of this time. One of those things which are related with the month of Ramadan, we mentioned that one is fasting and the other one is Quran. Alhamdulillah, we are fasting. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our fast. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to not make us mahrumeen, those who do the work, they make the effort, and then they don't get the benefit. Because Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, رُبَّ صَائِمٍ لَيْسَ لَهُ مِنْ صِيَامِهِ إِلْ جُوعُ وَالْعَطَشُ. There are many people, they keep fast, They do fast, but they don't get any benefit. They don't get anything, hunger and thirst. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala include us among those people who just waste their time and they don't get any benefit. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our fasting. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this fasting in our scale of good deeds on the day of judgment. The second thing which is related with this month is Qur'an. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned as-siyam wal-Qur'an yashfa'an lil-abdi yawm al-qiyamah. That fasting and Qur'an, they both will make intercession on the day of judgment for a servant. Siyam will come, fasting will come, and fasting will say, Allah, I stop him from eating and drinking and fulfilling his desires during the day. So accept my intercession in him. And Quran will say, oh Allah, I stopped him from sleeping during the night, having rest in the night. And he was standing in the night and he was listening Quran. So please accept my intercession in him. This is what Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. That this month of Ramadan is the month when Quran was revealed. The scholars and our rightly guided predecessors, they mentioned that all these things, whatsoever they are, if anything has got any greatness, if anything has got any distinction, if anything has got any significance, then it is because of Quran. When Quran was revealed during the month of Ramadan became distinguished and it became excellent and it became a great month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made obligatory fasting during this month. When this Quran was revealed during the night of decree, then this night became significant and a great night. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. That this month, this night, the night of Qadr, it is better than 1,000 months. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, حَابِيمُ وَالْكِتَابِ الْمُبِينِ إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةٍ مُبَارَكٍ إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةٍ مُبَارَكٍ. That we revealed this Quran in a blessed night. So the month became blessed. The night became blessed. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose his heart and his chest, his noble chest, for the revelation of Quran. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he became a leader of all the prophets. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him that position which was not given to anyone before him. So this is Quran. On the basis of this Quran, people, they get distinction, they get significance, and they get greatness. And that's why Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْفَعُ بِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ أَقْوَابًا وَيَضَعُ بِهِ آخَرِينَ. Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he was Khalifa and Amir al-Mu'mineen. And he came to Mecca, and there was one servant. But this servant, he was knowledgeable. He had Qur'an with him, knowledge of Qur'an, and he was Hafiz of Qur'an. And he made him as a leader of Mecca, as a representative of Umar in Mecca. And when Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu was going back, one of the companions of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam met him on the way. And he said that, who did make you a representative in Mecca? He said, such and such person. He said, he's just a mawali, min mawalina. He is only a servant from our servants. And then Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, you don't know that he is a qari'ul Quran. He is the one who has knowledge of Quran. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, inna Allah yarfa'u bi hadha al-kitabi aqwaban wa yad'u bihi akharin. That this Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise the rank of certain people with this Quran. And those people which are not given a higher rank, and they are humiliated, and they don't have any respect, it will be only because of this Quran. So my brothers, we need to know that this Quran is a great book of Allah. This is the last book of Allah. This is the word of Allah. Kalamullah. This is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So how we can get benefit during this month of Ramadan from this Quran? There are certain rites of Quran which the scholars have mentioned. Very briefly, I would like to share with you these rites of Quran and how we should interact with Quran. The first thing, and the most important thing, is that we believe in this Quran, that this is the book of Allah. Many people, they forget this. They forget this when they mention the rites of Quran. They don't mention that the most important one, the most significant one, the fundamental right of this Quran is that we believe in this Quran, that this is the book of Allah. This is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina utul kitab, aminu bima nazzalna musaddiqan lima ma'akum. Min qabli an natmisa wujuhan, wa naruddaha ala adbariha, au nal'alahum kama la'anna ashab as-sabt. O people of the book, believe in this Quran. Believe in this Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the people who are the believers, يا أيها الذين آمنوا آمنوا بالله ورسوله والكتاب الذي نزل على رسوله والكتاب الذي أنزل من قبله. Oh, you who believe in Allah, oh, you believe in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, believe in this Quran, believe in this Quran which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the first right of this Quran is that we believe that this is the book of Allah. لا يأتيه الباطل من بين يديه ولا من خلفه تنزيل من حكيم حميد. That anything which is wrong cannot be entered into Quran. Nobody can put anything wrong in this Quran. Anything which is batil, which is not haq, it will not come from this Quran. لا يأتيه الباطل من بين يديه وَلَا مِنْ خَلْفِي. Not from the right, not from the front, not from the back. Nothing will be included in this Quran if it is batil. Even if people, they want to do it, nobody can do it, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken the responsibility. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken the responsibility to preserve it. إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. Therefore, this Quran is the last word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِّنْ أَمْرِنَا مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِيمَانِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that you did not know what was the book, what was Iman, what was Islam. You didn't know anything about this. مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِيمَانِ وَلَكِنْ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُورًا نَهْدِي بِهِ مَنْ نَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this Quran as a noor, as a light. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this Quran as a light. And now because of this light, أَوَمَنْ كَانَ مَيِّتًا. If somebody who did not have life, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him life with this Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him light, and now he is walking through with this light. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ لِتُخْرِجَ النَّاسَ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ إِلَى صِرَاطِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَمِيدِ. That this is the book which we reveal to you. And because of this book, we have given you a light, a noor. قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ نُورٌ وَكِتَابٌ مُبِينٌ يَهْدِي بِهِ اللَّهُ مَنِ اتَّبَعَ رِضْوَانَهُ سُبُلَ السَّلَامِ. If somebody wants to follow the straight path, then it is not possible without Quran. يَهْدِي بِهِ اللَّهُ مَنِ اتَّبَعَ رِضْوَانَهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ لِتُخْرِجَ النَّاسَ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ أَوَمَنْ كَانَ مَيْتًا فَأَحْيَيْنَاهُ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made this Quran a light. All the people are in the darkness, no matter whatsoever they have got in terms of knowledge or in terms of discoveries, in terms of scientific development or anything. If this knowledge is not based on revelation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِن يَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا الظَّنَّ وَإِنْهُمْ إِلَّا يَخْرُصُونَ. ذَلِكَ مَبْلَغُهُمْ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ. That their knowledge and their all their knowledge is just a dhan, conjecture, nothing else. This Quran is the real knowledge. So that is the first thing which we need to know about Quran, that this Quran is a word of Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has preserved it until the day of judgment. And nobody can put anything wrong in this Quran. And this Quran is a light. If somebody wants to get the straight path, it is not possible without this Quran and without Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The second thing about the rights of Quran is that we recite this Quran. We do tilawa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, اُتْلُ مَا أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَأَقِّمِ الصَّلَاةِ إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَلَذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ. This Quran is a dhikr. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, dhikr means a reminder, a remembrance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that you read this Quran. Utlu ma uhiya ilayk. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, warattil al-Quran tartila. You read this Quran in a beautiful way, in a proper way, with the rules and regulations, and not in a hurry. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اِقْرَأُ الْقُرْآنِ. O people, read this Quran. Do tilawa of this Quran. فَإِنَّهُ يَأْتِي يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ شَفِيعًا لِأَصْحَابِ. That this Quran will come on the day of judgment as an intercessor for someone who has been reading this Quran. So the second right of this Quran is that we read this Quran. We recite it. And we recite it according to the rules, according to the regulations, according to the tajweed. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, there is not any excuse. Nobody can say that I am old person, I cannot read, and the words are difficult. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, if somebody reads Quran, wa huwa mahir, and he has the knowledge, he has the mahara, he has the capability, he will be among ma'a kirami safarat al-barara. He will be among those people, those who are the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if somebody reads Quran and it is difficult for him, wa huwa shaqun alayhi, if somebody reads Quran and this is difficult for him, falahu ajran. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that he will get two ajr. So there is not any excuse. And as I said before, that we do a lot for all other things, for our worldly things. We spend 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, and we get our degrees, we get our qualifications, we get our professional knowledge and so many other things. And people, they don't have their language. That is not their native language. They learn the language and they do interpretation for other people. If you do this for other, what about Quran if you do not understand Quran? If you do not have the time, if you do not have the capability, if you do not have the desire, so that you can understand Quran directly. So how we say that this Quran is difficult? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ بِالْمُدَّكِرِ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا يَسَّرْنَاهُ بِلِسَانِكَ لِتُبَشِّرَ بِهِ الْمُتَّقِينَ, that we made this Quran easy. We made this Quran easy. And we revealed this Quran in Arabic. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ قُرْآنًا عَرَبِيًّا لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. So this is the third. This is the third rite of Quran. And it is also related with this one, that when we recite Quran, we recite with reflection. Tadabbur, tafakkur, ta'aqqul. So these are the things we have to do when we are reading Quran, not just reading Quran and we do not understand that what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in this Quran. That is our problem nowadays. We have taken this Quran only as a book of reward, a holy book. We just read it. We just kiss this Quran. We just put this Quran on our eyes. We put this Quran on our heart, on our chest. But we do not reflect. And we do not ponder upon this Quran, that what Quran is asking, what is demanding, what are the commandments, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed in this Quran. We have forgotten it. And that very, very awful and very shameful and very sad situation, that we have forgotten this Quran from this scenario, in this regard. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. If somebody has forgotten this Quran, he has put this Quran back, and he has turned away from this Quran, فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ, then his life will be depressed. There is no satisfaction in his life. His life will be depressed. فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that on the day of judgment, when we will resurrect him, he will be blind. He will not have the eyes. He will not be able to see. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he would say, قَالَ رَبِّي لِمَ حَشَرْتَنِي أَعْمَى وَقَدْ كُنْتُ بَصِيرًا. Oh Allah, oh my Lord, I had my eyes, I could see when I was in dunya. So why you have resurrected me and I am blind? I cannot see. قال كذلك أتتك آياتنا فنسيتها وكذلك اليوم تنسى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say that my verses came to you, Quran came to you, the verses of Quran came to you, and you forgot them. You turned away from them. You put them in the back. And you forgot this Quran. الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى. Like you forgot my verses, today you will be forgotten. So my brothers, my sisters, we have to, alhamdulillah, we are in Ramadan. And as I said to you last time that, alhamdulillah, we are staying at home in a kind of isolation and in a kind of social distance. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned, ni'matani maghbubun feehima kathirun minan nas, that there are two ni'mah, there are two blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many people, they get benefit from these two ni'mahs, from these two blessings. And they don't understand, they don't realize that they are in great blessings. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned these two blessings, as-sihhat wal-faragh. As-sihhat wal-faragh. Somebody is in healthy situation. He is in a full health. He is not sick. He is not feeling ill. And also al-faragh, time. So now, alhamdulillah, we have time. We are in our houses and we are with siha, with afiyah. And even then, if we do not strengthen our link with Quran, then when we are going to get the benefit of this Quran? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ لِيَتْدَبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ وَلِيَتَذَكَّرَ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. O my Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we reveal this Quran to you. And it is a blessed Quran. It is a blessed book. كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ. This is a blessed word. لِيَتْدَبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ, so that people, they can reflect upon the verses of this Quran. They can reflect on the ayahs of this Quran. وَلِيَتَذَكَّرَ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. And those people who have understanding, they get the benefit, they get the reminder from this Quran. So that's the third right of Quran. The first one is Iman. The second one is Tilawatul Quran. And the third one is reflection on this Quran and getting the knowledge of this Quran. And also I would say the hifaz of this Quran. So all these are related with the tilawa and with the tadabbur. And the other thing, the fourth one, which is related with the rights of Quran, is amal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and that is very bad situation, very sad situation, very painful situation. As I said before, that we just read it, we recite it, and we think that it is enough, and we don't follow this Quran. We don't implement this Quran in our lives. My brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَهَذَا كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed this Quran. فَاتَّبِعُوهُ, so that you follow it. فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَاتَّقُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. You follow this Quran and you have taqwa. And if you have taqwa and if you follow this Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have mercy upon you. فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَاتَّقُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. So if somebody is not following Quran, then this Quran, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Imma hujjatan laka aw hujjatan alayk. O people, be aware that this Quran is either an evidence for you, it is an evidence against you. Now, it is very unfortunate that we are Muslims, alhamdulillah, but our lives are not according to Quran. Our social life, our economic life, our political life, our family life, it is not according to Quran, my brothers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا مَا بَخِيَ مِنَ الرِّبَا إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that don't interact with riba. Don't deal with riba. Don't get involved in يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَأْكُلُوا الرِّبَا أَضْعَافُ مُضَاعَفَةً. But when we say to our brothers, our sisters, no doubt they come to the masajid. No doubt they do whatever Islam is asking them to do. Alhamdulillah, may Allah accept their deeds. But some of them, they say, how we can do our business? How can we do our business if we don't get involved with the banking, interest-based banking? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in Quran the wa'id, the punishment and the torment regarding this riba, which has not been mentioned with anything else. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهُ وَذَرُوا مَا بَقِيَ مِنَ الرِّبَا إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ فَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا فَأْذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. That if you don't leave, if you don't give up this riba, then you come and there is an announcement of fighting with Allah and His Messenger. Now you are fighting with Allah and His Messenger. How somebody can fight with Allah and His Messenger? فَأَذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. So my brothers, when we do tawbah during the month of Ramadan, please, if you are involved in any kind of this transaction, just get rid of it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَمَعَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. If somebody works hard, if somebody is really struggling to get the right path and to leave any kind of disobedience, any kind of sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help him. There are many other things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ إِنَّمَا الْخَمْرُ وَالْمَيْسِرُ وَالْأَنْصَابُ وَالْأَزْلَامُ رِجْسٌ مِّنْ عَمَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ. People in the West, they don't care. If there is any lottery they want to buy, no problem. And then they make masajid with the money of these lotteries. And people, they sell alcohol. And they write on their shops, هَذَا فَضْلٌ مِّنْ رَبِّي. They don't care. My brothers, this Quran, this is either an evidence for you or it is an evidence against you. You choose and you make the decision that this Quran is an evidence for you or it is against you. How you will do it? When you follow this Quran. وَهَذَا كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكٌ فَاتَّبِعُوهُ. That this Quran is a blessed. So you follow this Quran. وَاتَّقُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. My brothers, we live in a society where there are people. Some of them, they don't follow Quran. Some of them, they make fun of Quran. Some of them, they refute Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and it is my message for those people who sit in the parliament, who sit in other forums. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَدْ نَزَّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الْكِتَابِ أَنْ إِذَا سَمِعْتُمْ لَهِيُكَ وَيُسْتَهْزَأُ بِهَا فَلَا مَعَهُمْ حَتَّى يَخُوذُوا فِي حَدِيثٍ غَيْرِي إِنَّكُمْ إِذَا مِثْلُهُمْ. Those people who are making fun of Quran, those who are refuting Quran, those who are making legislation against Quran, and if you are being a part of them, you are like them. You are one among them. إِنَّكُمْ إِذَمْ مِثْلُهُمْ. So my brothers, we don't say, we do have the need, and we encourage our brothers, but these brothers must be practicing brothers and sisters. They remain steadfast on their deen wherever they go. They show light. They share the teachings of Quran with other people, rather than being silent and being part of this kind of legislation, which is not in accordance with Quran. So, amal according to the Quran in every sphere of life. I just mentioned few things, but it is in every sphere of life, in our social life, in our political life, in our family life, in our business, in our trade, everywhere. This Quran gives us guidance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَى وَيُبَشِّرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَبِيرًا. That this Quran guides you to the best way, to the righteous way. إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَى وَيُبَشِّرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And this Quran gives you the glad tiding if you are a believer. وَيُبَشِّرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ. And those who do good deeds. Those who do good deeds. Without good deeds, my brothers, my sisters, nobody can help you. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to his own uncle, he said to his own daughter, he said to his own auntie, Ya Fatima bint Muhammad i'mali لا أغني عنك من الله شيئا. يا عباس عم محمد نعمل لا أغني عنك من الله شيئا. يا صفية عمة محمد نعملي لا أغني عنك من الله شيئا. Oh my uncle, oh my auntie, oh my daughter, you have to do good deeds. If you come on the day of judgment without iman and without good deeds, and you say that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is my nephew, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is my father, nobody will help you. Nobody will help you. This is in Quran what we says. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Man ya'mal min as-salihati wa huwa mu'minun, fala kufrana li sa'yihi wa inna lahu katibun. Wa man ya'mal min as-salihati min dhakarin aw untha wa huwa mu'min, fala nuhyiyannahu hayatan tayyibah." وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْرَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Anyone, a male or a female, if somebody is a believer and then somebody is doing good deed, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take the care of the good deeds. فَلَا كُفْرَانَ لِسَعْيِهِ فَلَا كُفْرَانَ لِسَعْيِهِ. Your effort will not go in vain. Your effort will not go useless, rewardless. It will not happen. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ شَاكِرًا عَلِيمًا. There is not anyone who can appreciate good deeds more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is not anyone. So my brothers, we have to follow this Quran. We have to follow this Quran in our lives. That is more important. To believe in Quran, to recite Quran, to reflect upon Quran, and to follow this Quran. And the other thing is related with this Quran, and that is the fifth right of this Quran, that is preaching this Quran. Pass on the message of this Quran. This Quran is not a book only for Muslims. If somebody says that Quran is a book of Muslims, he's wrong. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is a messenger for all the humanity. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ جَمِيعًا إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ جَمِيعًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He's asking Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that you make this announcement that I am a messenger of Allah to all of you. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَةً لِلنَّاسِ بَشِيرًا وَنَذِيرًا. We did not send you but as a messenger, a giver of glad tidings and a warner for all the humanity. So like our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his prophethood, his messengership is for all the humanity, the same is Quran for all the humanity. It is a message from Allah, a statement from Allah, a declaration from Allah. If anybody is following any other declaration or any other statement or any other book apart from this Quran, then he will go straight to the hellfire. And if anybody is following anyone other than Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he will go astray and he will go to the hellfire. This Quran and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they both are lazim wa malzum. They are interrelated. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this Quran to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is the first one who followed this Quran. And he is the first one who followed the path of Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَنَّ هَذَا سِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلِ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ ذَلِكُمْ وَصَّاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed certain teachings in Quran. قُلْ تَعَالُوا وَاتْلُوا مَا حَرَّمَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَيْكُمْ أَلَّا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيَّا. Don't associate partner with Allah. Don't kill your children because of the poverty and hunger. And do good with your parents. And always rise for الشهادة لله, and do good with the orphans. So there are certain things in the end of Surah Al-An'am. I would suggest to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wa anna hadha sirati mustaqima, that this is my straight path. This is my straight path. Wa anna hadha sirati mustaqima fattabi'u, you follow this path. Wa la tattabi'u as-subul, and you don't follow any other path. Fatafarraqa bikum 'an sabili, and if you follow any other path, you will go astray. So this Quran is a statement, a message for all the humanity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَهَذَا بَيَانٌ لِلنَّاسِ. O people, this is a message for all of you. هَذَا بَيَانٌ لِلنَّاسِ وَهُدًى وَمَوْعِظَةٌ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. It is a guidance. It is a guidance. It is a reminder. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, هَذَا بَلَاغٌ لِلنَّاسِ. It is a declaration for all the humanity. وَلِيُنذَرُوا بِهِ, and you warn them with this Quran. وَلِيُنذَرُوا بِهِ وَلِيَعْلَمُوا, and let them know. وَلِيَعْلَمُوا أَنَّمَا هُوَ إِلَهُ وَاحِدٌ, that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my brothers, how we can pass on this message to other people if we do not understand this message ourselves? So we have to understand this Quran. We have to learn the knowledge of this Quran. And we have to follow this Quran in our lives. And we have to make this Quran as an evidence for us, so that this Quran will be an intercessor on the day of judgment for us. Then inshallah we will be able to pass on this message to other people. And the last thing, the last one, but not the least one. This Quran is a shifa. You know, if anybody is not feeling well, we go to the doctors. Alhamdulillah, it is a hukm from Allah. It is a hukm from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also told us to get shifa from this Quran, ruqya. So now many people, they have problems, they have stress, they have difficulties in their lives. It is why? Because we don't read Quran. It is why? Because we don't get shifa from Quran. Surah Al-Fatiha is shifa. To read 7 times and you to do ruqya with Surah Al-Fatiha 7 times, you read upon any water and you drink it. And then Surah Al-Baqarah, Prophet ﷺ said that if in any house this Surah Baqarah is recited, shaitan will not stay there. Now everybody says that somebody has done black magic to me and there is problem in our houses. How you can get the benefit when Quran is with you and you are not getting the benefit, and people, they are coming to your houses and they are reciting Quran or they are doing something else and nobody knows that who they are, whether they are believers or not, because there are people of every kind. So this ruqya shar'iyya, ayatul kursi, the last 2 ayahs from Surah Al-Baqarah, Aman al-Rasul up to the end, and Mu'awwadhatayn and Surah Al-Ikhlas, this is the minimum. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to recite these before going to sleep. And also, as I said that alhamdulillah we have time, I would suggest and I would recommend that everybody learns by heart all these things. So everybody has some part of Quran in his heart and he can read as a ruqya and he can read in the salah. And also Surah Mulk, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that there is one surah in Quran, it has 13 ayahs and this surah will come on the day of judgment and this surah will fight on behalf of the person who was reading this surah. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and this is Surah Al-Mulk, and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to recite this surah every day before going to sleep. So these are certain things which I mentioned about Quran, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us tawfiq so that we can get the benefit from this Quran. We have strong conviction, iman in this Quran, that this is the book of Allah and this is preserved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is the book of guidance, and it is a book of guidance, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if somebody followed this book, if somebody followed this guidance, then he will not be in any problem, not in any worries, not any grief. فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ إِنَّ يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي مَنْ فَمَنِ اتَّبَعَ هُدَايَ وَلَا يَضِلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى. He will not go astray and he will not feel, without any respect. So all these things are related with this Quran. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq during this month of Ramadan when we are in isolation, so we can understand this Quran, we can memorize this Quran, and we can make this promise with Allah that we will follow this Quran in our daily lives, in our practical lives, and we listen to this Quran during the night prayer. So inshallah, this Quran becomes an evidence for us and not against us on the day of judgment. So this is what was related with the Quran and the month of Ramadan. And other thing, my brothers, I would say about Makki Masjid, as you know that alhamdulillah, for many years I have been a part of this masjid and this is my own masjid. And still, alhamdulillah, I think that I am a part of this masjid. And as you know that the new building and the construction of Makki Masjid is going on. And alhamdulillah, only by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and only because of your generous donations, alhamdulillah, now we can see that the major part of the masjid has been accomplished, alhamdulillah. We can see the building, we can see the minaret, alhamdulillah. We can see that, alhamdulillah, something is there. Now, during this Ramadan, because in normal Ramadan, you go to masjid for Taraweeh, for Juma prayer, and for other prayers. But unfortunately, because of the circumstances and because of the situation, also according to the Sunnah, when we have such a situation that we have to stay isolated, this is also according to the Sunnah So alhamdulillah, there is not because you are not going to the masjid. Therefore, our brothers, they think that might be our congregation and our brothers to participate in the fundraising. So we need to remind them. So being sitting in Mecca, in Haram, I would strongly ask all my brothers and sisters that please donate generously. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was the most generous person, as I said to you before in my last lecture. And when it was Ramadan, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was so generous. The companions say that it was like it was very heavy wind, rih mursala, you know, very heavy storm. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was giving so much for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our brothers, they have put a target. They say that we want to raise £80,000, but I would say no, inshallah, more than £80,000, at least £100,000, inshallah, you will raise during this Ramadan. As I said before, this sadaqah and this charity, and this is special charity which you are giving for building the masjid, because this is lillah and this is sadaqah jariyah, continuous charity. Inshallah, as long as this masjid would remain there and people, they will do salah, they will read Quran, they will come and they will listen to khutbah and they do tarawih and everything in this masjid. And if you have just put only one brick and you have put only a little bit part in this masjid, in the building of this masjid, inshallah, you will get the ajr. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if somebody make a house of Allah in this dunya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make a house for him in the Jannah. So I will recommend very, please, don't be shy and don't be heedless. As long as you are in your houses, now everything is happening online, so you can participate in fundraising online. Inshallah, give generously. And you know, this sadaqah, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, yutfi'un nar, it will extinguish the fire of Jahannam. Inshallah, whatsoever you will give, and inshallah, you will see that your masjid will be completed. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين.
جزاكم الله خير. Quickly, we will do inshallah just a couple of questions and then inshallah we'll end with that. The first question is, should reading books of knowledge also continue in Ramadan?
Yes, of course. If you read Quran and if you read any book which is helpful in understanding Quran, like tafsir or any other book, the book of seerah, the book of biography of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the books of ahadith, you know, all this knowledge is related with Quran, because as I told you that we cannot understand Quran without Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If somebody wants to understand Quran without Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is misguided. He will go to astray. Those people who are the companions of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they were in the time of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, like Abu Musa Ash'ari, and in Quran Allah says, "Hatta yatabayyan lakum al-khayt al-abyad min al-khayt al-aswad min al-fajr," about the timing of fasting, and he had a kind of thread under his pillow, and he wanted to see that when he can make the difference in the white one and in the black one. So that was his understanding. But Prophet ﷺ said, no, this is not the meaning of this ayah. So it means that if those companions, they were not able to get the meaning of Quran without the help of Prophet ﷺ, so how we can get it? Therefore, anything which is related with Quran in terms of ahadith, in terms of the seerah, in terms of any other books on Islam, inshallah, it will help us understanding Quran.
Jazakumullah khair. The next question is, please advise us if there is a difference in reward for reading the Quran and listening to the Quran.
You know, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says that اقرأوا القرآن فإنه يأتي يوم القيامة شفيعا لأصحابه. If somebody is reading Quran, then obviously he will get more ajr. There is no doubt in it. But it is also from the Sunnah to listen to Quran, and that's why we listen to Quran during Taraweeh prayer. And also Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allahu Akbar, once he said to Ubay bin Ka'b, "Oh Ubay, you come and you read to me." And he said, "Oh Allah's messenger, this Quran was revealed upon you and you are asking me that I should read this Quran to you." Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered me to listen from you. Allahu Akbar. And Ubay said, "Allah mentioned my name. Did Allah mention my name?" Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Yes, Allah mentioned your name." And Ubay was crying that Allah mentioned my name. And Allah said that you read Quran to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So in both, inshallah, you get the ajr. Both you get the ajr. But if somebody is reading Quran, he will get more ajr, inshallah.
Jazakumullah khair. One of the sisters, she asked that she puts the Quran on the radio or on YouTube while she is cooking, and she has it in the background. Is this okay? Is this permissible?
Yes, inshallah, there is nothing wrong. Alhamdulillah, our deen is simple, very logical. If you are doing some work at home and you are preparing food for your family, and at the same time you are listening to Quran, inshallah, you will get the ajr, and it is permissible. There is nothing wrong with it.
Jazakumullah khair. Is there still reward in reading the Quran in English, the English translation? Is there still reward, and is it less than reading it in Arabic?
My brothers, first we need to remember that Quran is what Allah has revealed. Quran is what Allah has revealed. And that is in Arabic. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Alif lam ra, tilka ayatul kitab al-mubin. Inna anzalnahu Qur'anan arabiyyan la'allakum ta'qilun. So this Quran was revealed in Arabic. So this is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If somebody is just reading the translation of Quran, so that is not Quran. That is only a translation. And if you read translation for getting knowledge, alhamdulillah, it is fine. But everyone must learn how to read Quran in Arabic. Everyone must learn how to read Quran in Arabic. And if somebody wants to read Quran, then he should read in Arabic. And for the knowledge, you can read English translation or any books in English or any tafsir in English. There is no problem, inshallah.
Jazakumullah khair. Last question. Is dua for witr meant to be done in the last half of Ramadan, or can it be done whenever?
Dua al-witr?
Yes. So the dua kunut in the witr.
Yes. You know, one thing is that it is the sunnah. It is not something which is fard or wajib. So if you just do only one raka'ah or three raka'ah or five raka'ah, your witr is valid, alhamdulillah. But Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he used to do sometimes in the before ruku and sometimes after ruku. So inshallah, this matter is yani there is wus'a, yani it is vast. So there is not any problem. You can do this du'a whenever you want, in the beginning or in the middle or in the end. As we say that this is the month of du'a as well. So inshallah, if you do du'a, inshallah, you will get the benefit. And as you know, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ad-du'a'u wal-ibadah, wal-du'a'u bukhul ibadah." So du'a, unfortunately, some of our brothers, you know, especially our brothers, I would say that those who say that we follow Quran and Sunnah, we have seen them that they are very heedless about the du'as. They don't do du'a. They say, "Oh, I just follow the Sunnah. I do this." Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to do a lot of du'a, my brothers and sisters, especially during the month of Ramadan, and especially in the night prayer. And inshallah, if you do du'a, whether this is Salatul Witr or without this, this is the time of iftar, inshallah, it will be beneficial.
Barakallah. That's all the questions, inshallah. Jazakallah for your time, inshallah. We'll try to arrange another topic in Ramadan in the coming days and weeks. Brothers and sisters, it's time for the Sheikh's iftar now in Saudi Arabia. So inshallah, we will allow him to go. And we just have a small announcement, inshallah, before we go. Sheikh, if you want to leave, that's fine, inshallah, no problem. We will continue.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Akhwatin o hazrat, mashallah, Ramzan aur Quran ke hawale se bahut khoobsurat lecture tha Dr. Hafiz Naeem Rehman sahab ka. Allah rabbul izzat unhe jazaya khair ata farmaye aur hame Allah taufeeq de ke hum jo hain wo Quran Majeed ko زیادہ سے زیادہ جو ہے اپنے تعلق کو قرآن مجید کے ساتھ جو ہے اس مہینے میں قرآن مجید کے ساتھ اپنے تعلق کو اس مہینے کے ساتھ مہینے میں ہم مضبوط کریں. حافظ نعیم الرحمن صاحب نے بھی آپ کو توجہ دلائی ہے اور میں بھی آپ کو ایک گزارش کرنا چاہتا ہوں. گزارش یہ ہے کہ آپ جانتے ہیں کہ الحمدللہ اس رمضان کے مہینے میں عام طور پہ پچھلے سال بھی اور پچھلے سے پچھلے سال یعنی جو پہلے جو سال گزرے ہیں ان سالوں میں ہماری کچھ مسجد کے حوالے سے ایکٹیویٹیز ہوتی تھیں, کچھ روٹین ہوتی تھی مسجد کے حوالے سے, لیکن اس سال بالکل ہر چیز جو ہے وہ تبدیل ہو گئی ہے, ہر چیز جو ہے وہ بدل گئی ہے. الحمدللہ رمضان کے مہینے میں آپ جانتے ہیں کہ ہماری مکی مسجد کا جو پروجیکٹ ہے جو چل رہا ہے نیو بلڈنگ کا, اس میں جو ہے وہ رمضان کے مہینے میں ہمیں الحمدللہ 70-80 to 90,000 پاؤنڈ جو ہیں وہ ساتھی جو ہیں وہ ریز کرتے تھے, ہم جمع کرتے تھے رمضان کے مہینے میں مسجد کے پروجیکٹ کے لیے. لیکن اس سال چونکہ ہم گھروں میں بیٹھے ہوئے ہیں, مسجد جو ہے وہاں ہم جو ہے وہ نماز کے لیے پہنچ نہیں سکتے ڈیو ٹو کووڈ 19, تو اس میں یہ جو مسجد کا جو تعمیر کا جو کام ہے وہ الحمدللہ جاری و ساری ہے. پچھلے دنوں بھائی رب نواز نے آپ کے ساتھ کچھ تصویریں شیئر کی تھیں جس میں جو ڈومر ہے مسجد کا وہ آپ کو بتایا گیا ہے کہ الحمدللہ کتنا وہ خوبصورت ویو ہے اس کا. تو مسجد کا جو تعمیر کا کام ہے وہ اللہ کے فضل و کرم سے جاری و ساری ہے, اور ہم بھی یہ چاہتے ہیں کہ یہ تعمیر کا کام جو ہے یہ اسی طرح جاری و ساری رہے, اس میں سٹاپ نہ ہو, اور یہ انشاءاللہ دن گزر جائیں گے اللہ کے فضل و کرم سے, یہ دن گزر جائیں گے. یہ گنتی کے دن رمضان کے بھی ہیں اور یہ ازمائش کے امتحان کے بھی گنتی کے دن ہیں, یہ گزر جائیں گے. تو ہم یہ چاہتے ہیں کہ ان دنوں میں زیادہ سے زیادہ مسجد کے لیے جو ہم حصہ ڈالتے تھے پہلے اس میں اور زیادہ تیزی پیدا کریں, کیونکہ یہ رمضان کا مہینہ جو ہے یہ اللہ کے راستے میں دینے کا مہینہ ہے, اور سب سے بہترین مصرف جو ہے وہ اللہ کے گھر کا تعمیر کرنا ہے. اور اللہ کے نبی صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کا یہ فرمانا کہ من بنا للہ مسجدن بن اللہ لہ مثلہ بیتن فی الجنہ, جو بندہ اللہ کے گھر کو تعمیر کرتا ہے اللہ اس سے بہتر جو ہے وہ اس کے لیے جنت میں محل تعمیر کر دیتے ہیں. تو آج الحمدللہ آپ لوگ جو ہیں وہ تعاون کر رہے ہیں مسجد کے ساتھ, لیکن اب چونکہ ہم سب گھروں میں بیٹھے ہوئے ہیں تو یہ ہمارا ڈبل امتحان ہے. لیکن اس جو کرونا وائرس کی وجہ سے جو ہم گھروں میں بیٹھے ہوئے ہیں, اس آفت کو اللہ پاک ہم سے دور کر دے, وہ کیسے ممکن ہو سکتا ہے؟ ہم توبہ کریں اور توبہ کے ساتھ ہم صدقات کا بھی اہتمام کریں, اس لیے کہ الصدقۃ تدفع البلیا, صدقہ جو ہوتا ہے وہ آزمائشوں کو, مشکلوں کو, امتحانوں کو دور کرتا ہے. تو میری آپ سب سے, اپنی بہنوں سے, اپنے بھائیوں سے یہ التجا ہے کہ ہم ایک جو ہے وہ فنڈ ریزنگ اپیل لانچ کر رہے ہیں مکی مسجد کے پلیٹ فارم پر, اور انشاءاللہ اگر عام رمضان کے اندر جو روٹین کے اندر رمضان ہوتا تھا ہم 80-90,000 پاؤنڈ جو ہے وہ اکٹھا کرتے تھے, تو انشاءاللہ اس وقت جب کہ ہم ایک امتحان میں گزر رہے ہیں تو انشاءاللہ ہم نے 1,00,000 کا جو فگر ہے اس کو ہم نے کراس کرنا ہے. اور یہ کیسے ممکن ہو سکتا ہے؟ یہ اس طرح ممکن ہو سکتا ہے کہ میں, آپ اور ہر ایک جو مکی مسجد کے ساتھ متعلق ہے, مکی مسجد کے ساتھ جس کا تعلق ہے, وہ خود بھی اپنے عزیز و اقارب کو بھی دعوت دے کہ وہ مکی مسجد کے لیے یہ جو ہم اپیل جو ہے وہ لانچ کر رہے ہیں اس میں حصہ ڈالیں اور مسجد کی تعمیر کے لیے جو ہے آپ اپنا تعاون پیش کریں, اور انشاءاللہ آپ خود بھی پیش کریں, آپ کا بھی جو ہے وہ آپ کے لیے باعث اجر بنے گا, اور اس کے ساتھ جو ہے آپ خود بھی پیش کریں, اور اس کے ساتھ جو ہے آپ اپنے دوست و احباب کو بھی دعوت دیں. اور نبی اکرم صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے فرمایا الدال علی الخیر کفائلہ, جو کسی کو نیکی کی طرف دعوت دیتا ہے وہ ایسے ہی ہوتا ہے جیسے وہ خود نیکی کر رہا ہے, تو آپ کا ڈبل جو ہے وہ انشاءاللہ ریوارڈ ہوگا, ڈبل اجر ہوگا آپ کا, ایک خود دینے کا اور دوسرا آپ جن کو مسجد میں دینے کے لیے دعوت دیں گے, اور انشاءاللہ قطرے قطرے سے جو ہے وہ دریا بن جاتا ہے, اور اللہ کے فضل و کرم سے انشاءاللہ مجھے امید ہے اللہ کی رحمت سے امید ہے, اور اپنے بھائیوں اور اپنی بہنوں سے امید ہے کہ انشاءاللہ ہم اپنی ذمہ داری کا احساس کرتے ہوئے جو مکی مسجد کے حوالے سے ہمارے اوپر بنتی ہے, اور مجھے یہ خوشی ہو رہی ہے کہ آپ دیکھ رہے ہیں الحمدللہ کہ ہماری مسجد جو ہے وہ کتنی ایکٹیو ہے, بچوں کی تعلیم جو ہے وہ آن لائن جاری ہے, آپ کے دروس جو ہیں وہ آن لائن جاری ہیں, آپ کا قرآن کا خلاصہ آن لائن جاری ہے, ابھی آپ چند لمحے پہلے مکے کے اندر جو ہے آپ ماشاءاللہ شیخ صاحب کی جو ہے وہ گفتگو سن رہے تھے, تو الحمدللہ یہ مسجد کی ایکٹیویٹیز اسی طرح جاری و ساری ہیں. تو آپ کو میں یہ دعوت دیتا ہوں کہ آج ہم ایک اپیل لانچ کر رہے ہیں, آپ اس اپیل کے اندر جو ہے وہ خود بھی تعاون کریں, عزیز و اقارب دوست و احباب کو ہر بندہ اپنے ذمے جو ہے وہ ایک ٹارگٹ مقرر کرے کہ میں نے انشاءاللہ اس سال جو ہے وہ مسجد کو اتنا جو ہے وہ تعاون دلوانا ہے, تو اللہ کے فضل و کرم سے اگر ہر بندہ اپنی ذمہ داری کا احساس کرے تو وما ذلک علی اللہ بعزیز, یہ مشکل نہیں ہے, یہ انشاءاللہ آسان ہوگا, اور اللہ کے فضل و کرم سے ہم جو ہمارا عام روٹین کے اندر 80,000 or 90,000 پاؤنڈ ہم رمضان میں مسجد کے لیے اکٹھا کرتے تھے, مجھے انشاءاللہ امید ہے کہ ہم 1,00,000 سے بھی جو ہے وہ انشاءاللہ ہم کراس کر جائیں گے. تو میری آپ سے یہ گزارش ہے, آپ کے سامنے یہ جو ہے یہ مکی مسجد رمضان 2020 فنڈ ریزنگ اپیل جو ہے وہ آپ کے سامنے ہے, آپ اس کو دیکھ سکتے ہیں, اور آپ سے یہ درخواست ہے کہ آپ بڑھ چڑھ کے, اور انشاءاللہ یہ بات یاد رکھیے, ہمیں احساس ہے اس بات کا کہ اس وقت لوگوں کے جو مالی حالات ہیں فنانشل جو ہے وہ کیا کہتے ہیں کہ سچویشن جو ہے وہ قدرے مختلف ہے پہلے سے, لیکن آپ یقین کیجئے کہ جن کو اللہ تعالیٰ نے دل کی غنات دے رکھی ہے, جو دل کے غنی ہیں وہ کبھی بخل سے کام نہیں لیتے, ان کے ہاتھ اللہ کے فضل و کرم سے دینے والے ہیں, اور وہ خاص طور پہ نیکی کے ان کاموں میں بڑھ چڑھ کے حصہ ڈالتے ہیں, اور انشاءاللہ اگر بندہ اس وقت خرچ کرے جب اس کو خود ضرورت ہو اور اس کے پاس کم ہو پھر اللہ کے رستے میں وہ خرچ کرے, اللہ بھی اس کی بڑی قدر کرتا ہے, اللہ بھی اس کو مور ریوارڈ دیتا ہے, اللہ بھی جو ہے اس کے دیے ہوئے کے اندر برکت ڈالتا ہے, اور اس کا دیا ہوا جو ہے وہ انشاءاللہ جس مقصد کے لیے وہ دیتا ہے اس میں بھی انشاءاللہ باعث برکت بنتا ہے. تو آج ہم جس سچویشن سے گزر رہے ہیں مایوس ہونے کی ضرورت نہیں ہے, اللہ پاک کی رحمت ہی رحمت ہے انشاءاللہ ہمارے اوپر, مایوس ہونے کی ضرورت نہیں ہے, بلکہ بڑھ چڑھ کے ہم جو ہے وہ مسجد کی اس اپیل کے اندر جو ہے وہ حصہ ڈالیں, لوگوں کو دعوت دیں, اور انشاءاللہ قطرے قطرے سے دریا بنتا ہے, اور آپ کے اس جذبے کی وجہ سے, آپ کی دعاؤں کی وجہ سے, آپ کے تعاون کی وجہ سے انشاءاللہ مسجد کا کام سٹاپ نہیں ہوگا, مسجد کا کام جو ہے وہ جاری ساری رہے گا, اور مسجد بلڈنگ کمیٹی کے جو ہمارے بھائی ہیں وہ ماشاءاللہ اسی طرح ان کی ایفرٹ جو ہے وہ اسی طرح ہے, اسی طرح ان کی کوششیں ان کی محنتیں ماشاءاللہ جو ہیں وہ جاری و ساری ہیں. اللہ رب العزت آپ کے رمضان کے روزوں کو بھی قبول فرمائے, رات کے قیام کو بھی قبول فرمائے, قرآن کی تلاوت کو بھی قبول فرمائے, اور اللہ تعالیٰ آپ کے ان صدقات کو جو آپ اللہ کے رستے میں مال خرچ کر رہے ہیں اللہ پاک اس کو بھی قبول و منظور فرمائے, اور اللہ پاک اس کی صدقات کی وجہ سے اللہ پاک آپ کے گھر میں, آپ کی اولاد میں, آپ کے عمل میں, آپ کے مال میں, آپ کی ہر چیز کے اندر اللہ پاک برکت ڈالے. جزاکم اللہ خیرن و بارک اللہ فیکم. انشاءاللہ ہم گاہے بگاہے آپ کے پاس جو ہے یہ اپیل لے کے حاضر ہوتے رہیں گے, اور مجھے امید ہے کہ جہاں تک میری آواز پہنچے گی, جو میرے بھائی اور بہنیں میری آواز سنیں گے وہ انشاءاللہ جیسے پہلے میں گزارش کرتا ہوں آپ جو ہے وہ لاج رکھتے ہیں, تو آج بھی انشاءاللہ آپ اسی طرح لاج رکھیں گے. جزاکم اللہ خیرا وبارک اللہ فیکم, والسلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ.